Get ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Clay. As we play the star-studded big money match game, PM. And now, here's the star of match game, PM, Gene Raber.
You're a nifty, lively bunch. We're happy to have you here, and you too. Shall we begin?
Why not?
Okay. Would you applaud Shelley Cheshire and Tom Hendricks? How do you do? Now, to begin the proceedings, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. And Tom, if you will, sir, we'll begin with you.
Okay, I'm a pharmaceutical salesman. I sell pharmaceutical... To veterinarians?
Now, the first thing you have to do, if you're going to sell us stuff, you got to know how to say the name of it. Yeah?
Well, I fell down and stubbed my tongue earlier today, so I'm having a problem. I sell pharmaceutical products to veterinarians, and I live in Manhattan Beach, California.
Okay. You married?
No, I'm single.
You fool around?
As much as possible.
Okay. Good luck to you, Tom. How about you, my dear?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Anything you'd like to say about Shelley Cheshire?
Shelley Cheshire is a traveling salesperson. I carry a men's sweater line on the road.
You what?
Carry a men's sweater line.
You carry a men's sweater line.
Yes.
Have you got a 42 long?
Excuse me, I'm in the wrong joke.
Yes. You're a traveling salesperson?
Yes.
We've never had one of those, have we?
I wish we had.
Happy to have you, Shelley.
Thank you.
Good luck to you, too, my dear.
Thank you.
Now, I point out to both of you that here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of these gifted, beautiful, handsome, lovely, adorable people as possible. And the one who does that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and we'll go on to play that big money super match, which can pay off over $10,000. Yeah. Here we go. Tom, I'm going to ask you to begin the proceedings by choosing A or B.
A.
A it is for Tom Hendricks. And this is it. Jim and Linda have a weird idea of what's fun. When they got married, they didn't spend their honeymoon in a hotel room. Instead, they spent 2 weeks in a blank room. 2 weeks in a blank room. Weird idea of what's fun. Right. It's up to you. All right, now we're ready. Tom. Jim and Linda have a weird idea of what's fun. When they got married, they didn't spend their honeymoon in a hotel room. Instead, they spent 2 weeks in a blank room.
Bathroom.
Really? I'd say that's mighty weird, wouldn't you, Bill?
Yes, and also weird was either men's room or ladies' room.
Oh, yes.
But I didn't know which one was weird, so I couldn't choose that. I moved them into a steam room.
Steam room would be good, too. That'd be weird, just... Now, wait a minute.
Hold it.
You are a hostile bunch. I'm going to have to call. Dr. Freud, would you come over right away, please, and talk to these people? What do you say?
What do I say? I don't consider that weird at all. Where did you spend your honeymoon when you weren't out walking around?
In the back seat of a Studebaker.
That's what I said.
Really?
No, I said cloakroom at the Plaza.
Cloakroom at the Plaza Hotel. Oh.
Right.
Don't encourage them,
always
Charles.
Always got to show everybody your first class. Cunard Line, Plaza Hotel. Oh, boy.
That's Cunard.
I wish you were all in a dark room.
Dark room. When they got married, they didn't spend their honeymoon in the hotel room and said they spent 2 weeks in a blank room, and he said bathroom. What do you say?
They're so hostile, I'm afraid to show my answer.
Well,
and you're
since
right.
You're a sweet young ingenue, maybe they won't boo you if you got a rotten answer.
Okay, bar room.
That's not a bad
drinking answer. Away, right?
That'd be weird. I agree that'd be a weird place to have a honeymoon there, wouldn't you?
Right on that.
Excellent. When I give mine, I want you to say why.
Okay.
I said a dark room.
Why?
Well, they wanted to see what would develop. Thank you.
Is there
I don't
any...
find them hostile at all.
No, they're... Anything I can do to straight for you, Miss Fanny, honey?
When I give you my answer... Don't ask me nothing. I said bar.
Bar room. Okay. So, Tom, you have your first rounder. Remember, they're tough. Shelley, this one is yours. Jake the Hillbilly said, I am downright disappointed with the U.S. Post Office.
At this barn door.
I'm going to tell you how. When my mail order bride arrived, she was blank. What do you think of that? Downright disappointed at the U.S. Post Office.
I don't like it.
It's all right. Here we go. Shelley. Jake the Hillbilly said, I'm downright disappointed with the U.S. Post Office. Why, when my mail order bride arrived, she was blank.
Opened?
Opened. Illegally. I mean, I guess we'd better just get on with it. Just move along quickly.
I wish I had thought of that.
Me too.
I do too.
A lot of the things happen in the post office.
Right.
Pregnant is what she was.
Pregnant. Yeah. When my mail order bride arrived, she was pregnant. Right.
Winning him back.
Somebody had been tampering with the male. Or the female in this case.
That's life. I said she was broken.
She was broken. They do that, too. They throw those boxes around and...
Moving right on.
Yes.
I said she was overdue.
Overdue. Getting some interesting responses here, Shelley, but none that you want. She wants opened.
I said canceled.
Canceled. All right. What do you say to this?
I wish I'd said underdue, but I said over.
You said overdue. Overdue. Yeah. Overdue. You, Fanny, what'd you say, honey?
I said she was damaged.
Oh. Damaged. And I don't accept damaged goods. I will have nothing to do with it. So there we are at the end of round one. We have no score, but that's the way it goes here sometimes. We hope to score later, don't we? Thank you. Right now we got this.
Could regular toothpaste clean away plaque like Arm & Hammer Dental Care? Perhaps, if they had our high baking soda formula. They don't. It's patented. Arm & Hammer cleans plaque away better. Feels like a dentist cleaning every time you brush.
You could have softer, smoother cheeks in just 7 days. If those cheeks are in Pampers Premium. Our Gentle Touch Liner Plus Aloe can mean softer skin, smoother skin in just 7 days. When you pamper the skin, they're in. Looking for this? Philadelphia cream cheese. Smooth, creamy. A bagel without it? Heaven forbid.
I'm Judge Joseph Wapner. If you were awarded a structured settlement or lottery winnings payable over time, then I suspect you feel your money is all locked up. Singer Asset Finance has the key to unlock your money's potential by paying you a lump sum. Right now. Call now for your qualifying analysis, then receive this information kit free. Enjoy the benefits of your money now. A new home, money for college, a change in lifestyle.
For your free qualifying analysis, call 800-552-3829 now.
Since we have a tie score in this tight game, Since you went first last time, Tom, we're going to ask Shelley to go first this time.
I'm going to try B.
B. Anything you wish is our command. Albert invented an amazing talking bathroom scale. When his 300-pound wife got on it, it yelled, blank! Okay, Shelley. Albert invented an amazing talking bathroom scale. When his 300-pound wife got on it, it yelled, blank! Think about it now.
I have.
Now, just look at them. What do you think they would write? And help. That's what you're going to say. Help. She said help. What do you say? Ouch.
Ouch.
Ouch. What do you say?
Get off me.
Get off me. Chuck, she's looking for help.
She'll get help.
Help.
But, see, I got the deluxe scale that goes a little further than that. It goes help, wide load.
Help, wide load. There's one for her. What do you say, Debbie Lee?
Help!
Help! That's good for you. Richard?
Help part two.
Help part two. And the 300-pound wife got out and she yelled,
get off.
Get off. Well, you picked up three. That ain't bad, is it?
No.
They're getting a little easier as we go along, Tom, as you'll find out. Herbie has the world's longest tongue.
Oh.
You're going to find out. Uh-huh. His tongue is so long, at night, if you go up... His tongue is so long, at night before he goes to sleep, he ties it around his blank. Yeah, that's a very easy one. At night before he goes to sleep, he ties it around his blank.
Oh, well.
Ready?
Yeah.
Herbie has the world's longest tongue. His tongue is so long, at night before he goes to sleep, he ties it around his blank.
His nose.
His nose.
What else?
I don't know. There may be some interesting answers over here. Shall we find out together, Tom? Okay, Bill, you're first.
Just my luck.
Neck.
Ties it around his neck. Mm-hmm. What do you say?
Well, I went a whole different route.
Yes.
Which is unusual for me because I'm usually following the troops. No, I said wife. He was...
Terrific.
Wait,
she loved it. Right. Okay, didn't want to leave her. What do you say?
The French have a word for it. No, yeah. I said bedpost.
Bedpost. That's a good answer. Some interesting answers there, Tom. Yours was not bad. These are interesting, too. Deborah Lee?
Neck.
Neck, another good one. Tied it around his...
Toe.
Now, that was a long tongue. What do you say to this?
His toe. I said he put it around his pillow.
Tied it around his pillow. All right, so there's the end of round two. Shelley is ahead 3-0. We go to round three, and Shelley, since you are ahead, we're going to ask you to go first.
I'm going to try B again.
B again. Three people play. Bill, Brett, and Fanny. Here it is. Oh. The garbage man said... Things have gotten pretty rough for the people on my route. Nowadays, they don't give me their garbage. I have to blank it. Things have gotten pretty rough. Okay? Shelley? Garbage man said, things have gotten pretty rough for the people on my route. Nowadays, they don't give me their garbage. I have to blank it. Things have gotten pretty rough for the people on my route.
They don't give me... their garbage, I have to pay for it.
Buy it, pay for it. I have to buy it, she says, or pay for it. What do you say, Bill?
Well, I come from a rough town. Steal it.
I have to steal it. Yes?
Or, in the vernacular of the young folk, rip it off.
Rip it off. Two steals so far.
I'm not playing.
Oh, that's right. You're not playing, but you are.
I'm playing.
Yes. What do you say?
She said, buy it.
Yes, buy it or pay for it.
How odd. I said that.
Ah, she said it too. So now, Shelley, you have four altogether. That means Tom has to match four to tie. 5 to win. And, Tom, since you haven't matched anyone yet, everyone will play. Brett said.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Uh-oh. Be careful.
She said, I just saw Fanny Flagg's IQ score. And she said, and guess what? It's the same as her blank. Okay. You ready, Tom? Brett said, I just saw Fanny Flagg's IQ score, and guess what? Fanny's IQ is the same as her blank.
Her bust.
It don't make her too smart, but it sure make her shapely. What do you say?
By golly, Pike's Peak or...
That's it. So that's 4-1 is the score now. What do you say to this?
Hook up, Tom. All is not lost, my darling. I should bust line or brass side.
There it is. 2 for him. Scores 4-2.
That's insulting to Fanny, who is a very intelligent and lovely young woman. So I said her bust measurement time is 5.
Uh-huh. I would give her an IQ of 450.
Sweetness.
Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. What do you want to
I
do here?
I said bra size.
Bra size. So that's 4-4 now.
One more.
We have a tie score at this moment. One more, or two more, as the case may be, and Tom will have won the game.
This is a bright, intelligent lady, and I happen to know that her IQ... score is the same as her social security number.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
846. I will not do a chauvinistic joke for her.
827.
No, I refuse to be chauvinistic about this bright, intelligent child.
Yes. What about her?
Of course, her number, by the way, on the card is 7.
Thank you. You are a gentleman. I'm going to kill Brett when I get her upstairs. Bra size. I knew she
Sir, you can hang around right there if you would, please. Shelley, we're going to part company with you, but it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much.
And we thank you very much for being with us here on Match Game PM. Shelley Cheshire, ladies and gentlemen. While we're spinning her off, we want to spin these messages for you. Heard that? See how he does in a big way.
Are you paying too much for prescription drugs? For eyeglasses and eye exams? Too much for dental care for you and your family?
Now, there is something you can do about it. Get the card from Universal Benefit Systems. It can save you money every time you use it. The UBS card qualifies you and your family for discounts on prescriptions, eyeglasses, and dental care. And it's so easy to use. Just present your card when you pay and save up to 40% on prescriptions, up to 50% on eyeglasses and contact lenses, and save up to 30% on dental care. If your insurance lacks coverage, for just $5.95 a month, you and your family can enjoy discounts on prescriptions, glasses, and dental care. And you can't be turned down. Your UBS card is welcome at more than 50,000 pharmacies, vision care stores, and dentists across the country, including Walgreens, Pearl Vision, and many more. Just present your UBS card when you pay, and you get the discount immediately. The potential savings are unlimited, and there are no forms, qualifications, or physicals. One card for the whole family. All for just $5.95 a month. And you can't be turned down. With the rising cost of medical care, your UBS card could pay for itself the first time you use it. Call now for your free information kit and join the more than 300,000 people who are saving money every day. You have nothing to lose. If you're not satisfied, just return the card within 60 days and we'll refund your money. No questions asked. This is a smart plan and an easy one. Just show your card when you pay, and you pay less.
Call 1-800-367-1900 for your free information kit or to join UBS now. Save on prescription drugs, eyeglasses, eye exams, and dental care for you and your whole family. Remember, you can't be turned down. The potential savings are unlimited. Call 1-800-367-1900 now.
Here we are with Tom Hendricks, and at this time, it's time for this big money super match where Tom can win over $10,000. Now, Tom, to do that, we're going to have two audience matches for you here, and whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll multiply by 10, and that'll be the final dollar figure you'll be playing for. Let's begin right now. Not too long ago, we had a bunch in this studio, and we locked all the doors, and we gave them blunt writing instruments, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Nutty blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most frequently, you get $500. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third most popular, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities are allowed to help.
Okay, I want Richard.
Richard, what do you say to this?
Jerry Lewis picture, and the Nutty Professor.
Nutty Professor was a Jerry Lewis picture, right.
Okay, Charles.
Charles?
What the neighbors used to say when I was a child in Hartford. Nutty is a fruitcake.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, Fanny.
Fanny, think about it now.
Oh, I have it. I used to eat them. Nutty Buddies.
Nutty Buddies. It's a candy bar, right? Okay, Nutty Buddies, Nutty is a Fruitcake, and Nutty Professor. You got three there. It's your option now to choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Professor.
Nutty Professor is the one you want, the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if we've got a Nutty Professor up there, and if so, where may we see the $100 response? You've got it right off the bat. Congratulations. So, you've picked up $100 here, and that means the least amount you'll be playing for will be 10 times that, or $1,000. Okay? Now we're going to go on here, and let's see what's up on the $250 number. Nutty Buddy. That's the one that Fanny gave you. Nutty's a fruitcake? You're probably right, because you look pretty smart to me. All right, slide it, please. Nutty's a fruitcake again. Okay. Now we congratulate you, Tom. You're going along here okay. Let's see if you can improve it a little more now as we go to the next audience match. We polled another studio audience, and we said, give us your best answer to this. Blank Charles. Okay.
Richard again.
Of course, being French, Prince Charles.
Naturally.
Thank you.
All of you French people think of Prince Charles immediately.
Okay, Bill.
Ray Charles.
Ray Charles. Ray
Charles.
Charles. Charles?
Nelson, no. Ezra Charles.
Ezra Charles.
Is that right?
Yeah. Ezra Charles, the boxer.
Yeah.
Right.
What was his name?
A great fighter.
Ezra Charles. Ray Charles, and Prince Charles.
I hope he beats everyone up.
Are the three. You want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own?
I'll take Ray Charles.
You take Ray Charles. Okay. We're looking for Ray Charles. May we see the $100 number? St. Charles.
Oh, how sweet I'm on there.
Another great singer. All right. May we see the $250 number? Prince Charles. Oh, well,
since
he had
they
a
devalued,
voice like a nightingale.
No, they devalued the pound. He would have
been
up there.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, he should have been 500.
I didn't take that into consideration,
that's
did I?
True. All right, last chance for Ray Charles. Go. You got it. Oh, come. Candy bar. Yeah. Okay. Now, another $500 multiplied by 10 gives you $5,000. Added to the previous $1,000, you got a pot of $6,000 to shoot for here. And we will be delighted to give you the money if you'll just match one celebrity exactly.
Okay, Richard.
Okay, Richard. Now, you just stand on that little blue dot in the carpet there. But you can't look at him while he's writing, because that wouldn't be fair now, would it? Because you could see what he's writing. Just face me there. Man, this dance, do the waltz, and you want to lead. All right, here we go. Good luck to you. Get your ESP going. It is reads as follows. Impossible blank. Impossible blank. Now he's finished, Tom. Give us the answer he's written. We give you $6,000. Impossible blank.
Dream.
Impossible dream. Turn around. Okay. He says Impossible Dream will match you for $6,000. What do you say, Richard?
I wish it did. Oh, it does.
It does. We have a grand total of $6,600. Boy, Tom.
Coming up next on Game Show Network.
Hi, I'm Marianne Curran. I know you get the Final Jeopardy questions correct when you play at home. Now Game Show Network is inviting you to play Final Jeopardy. Here's how it works. Watch Jeopardy at its regular time and channel. Then watch Game Show Network. Every night I'll present a Final Jeopardy question. Using your touch-tone phone, you'll have a chance to play Final Jeopardy at home.
Catch Final Jeopardy right after Match Game next on Game Show Network. Watch Game Show Network for a chance to win these prizes. Now available, Merriam-Webster's Collegiate Dictionary. Deluxe audio edition includes 100,000 spoken pronunciations and 1,000 color illustrations from Merriam-Webster Incorporated. Coordinated wallpapers and borders from Waverly's Heirloom Collection transform your home from ordinary to extraordinary. The magic of wallpaper. The magic of Waverly. Veriflex inline skates are durable and a step ahead with their designs. Speed bearings, urethane wheels, and shock-absorbing footbeds make Veriflex an exciting skate to own.
Tom Hendricks here has won $6,600, and we'll have more money to give away next week on Match Game PM. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the Amana Touchmatic Radar Range, the Cookmatic Power Shift that allows complete control of cooking speeds before or as you cook. Remember, if it doesn't say Amana, it's not a radar range. And the Zenith Mini Wedge modular stereo with AM/FM radio, 8-track recorder, changer, and Allegro tune four speakers. At Zenith, the quality goes in before the name goes on. And Sale hand knitting yarns at DuPont Orlon to hand knit your labor of love. With dependable ones, stays new looking. And Recorder Call 80, automatic telephone answering system, voice actuated with remote control. It plays back your message from anywhere in the world. And Mr. Coffee, revolutionary 10 to 2 cup coffee saver. Joe DiMaggio says great coffee tastes without coffee waste, plus genuine Mr. Coffee filter. And Bardol's new fuel system treatment. Gasoline additive to help keep your entire fuel system clean from gas tank to carburetor. You'll feel the difference. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Hey, we've got a Game Show Network exclusive coming right up for you. It's your chance to play Final Jeopardy right at home and win. It's all happening next, only on Game Show Network.